valley east of Omaha. You can listen to the engine moaning out his one note song. You can think about the woman or the girl you knew the night before. But your thoughts will soon be wandering the way they always do when you're riding 16 hours and there's nothing much to do. And you don't feel much like riding, you just wish the trip was through. See, here I am on the road again. There I am up on the stage. Here I go playing star again. There I go, turn the page. Well, you walk into a restaurant strung out from the road, and you feel the eyes upon you as you're shaking off the cold. You pretend it doesn't bother you, but you just want to explode. Most times you can't hear them talk, other times you can. All the same old cliches, is that a woman or a man? And you always seem outnumbered, you don't dare make a stand. Here I am on the road again. There I am up on the stage. Here I go playing star again.
Okay, catapulting from my religious studies, where I have been seeking the ways of forgiveness for what I had done, and absolving the anger within my heart, I am flung back into the fray by the sentence imposed upon the January 6 Proud Boys. Whoever your lawyers were really were not working towards your best interests. All that was needed was to read the Declaration of Independence out loud in the courtroom to justify what you all had done. Instead, you have been labeled terrorists for standing up for your own country against the tyranny that Trump's administration had become. Even Moreso, you have allowed the corruption that was behind Trump to not only get away, but allowed that same corruption to convict you of this act you have done as a crime of terrorism. Let me quote once again the Declaration of Independence that absolves you of your crime and brings into question the actions being taken by the government, because by convicting these men, then by your own laws, you have absolved Donald Trump of his crimes against the people. So who is really running this show, Trump, or the corruption behind Trump that has eroded this country into what it is? Because to respond to this claim, that same corruption would have to manipulate their system to uphold their decision.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, that to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed, that whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its powers in such form. as to them shall seem, most likely to affect their safety and happiness, prudence, indeed. That if such tyranny should rule over and oppress its people, then the people are given the right and the duty to throw down such tyranny and abolish it from their lands, and a new set of government shall be established. It is their right, it is their duty, to throw off such government and to provide new guards for their future security. Such has been the patient sufferance of these colonies, and such is now the necessity which constrains them to alter their former systems of government. The history of the present King of Great Britain is a history of repeated injuries and usurpations, all having in direct object the establishment of an absolute tyranny over these states.
So bring all your court sorcerers and corrupt priests. I cast down before you my rod of truth and justice onto the floor, before you in symbolic representation of Moses, before the Pharaoh that challenge your corrupted laws. For I come on behalf of a greater law, guided by the inspiration of a greater authority, whom is God, that I trust, for he is my shepherd, and demand once again that you let my people go.
I am the Lord, creator of the heavens and the earth. I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am he who was, is, and is yet to be, the beginning and ending of all things. I am the God of your fathers, the God that appeared before Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I am, therefore, I am.
The Lamb, the Son.
Now, Mr. Modern, I have heard enough of your opinion and views that discredit my name for the sake of profit and fame. You think you know me, but you know nothing. I am the architect of creation. This universe, this world, was made in my image of what it should be. Life is an animate thing though, Mr. Modern. Creation is not. The fundamentals of life's evolution is what is to blame for all these problems you throw at me. You think your records of history are accurate, that they are finite enough to lump these issues that are of your own species' design onto me to be blamed for. God is not responsible for rape, murder, and evil, Mr. Modder. People are people who didn't think that morality mattered. Like you, Mr. Modder. Let me ask you something. With your rational process of thinking, I'm sure you've already thought of two or three dozens of reasons as to why I am not who and what I say. However, I'm not here to give you a spanking, Mr. Modder. That solution is for immoral parents, isn't that right? No, not your daddy. I'm not here to shake my finger at you and say do it again, and I'll fucking spank you. No, I am the creator of all that is, from the Alpha to the Omega of all things. You could not even fathom to grasp the very concept of the ground you stand on, sir, let alone anything about me. You think those descriptions about me are accurate. Let me clue you into something, John. Forget everything you have heard about, and learn, because it's intentionally not true. I am not a being of perfection, or an immaculate being of omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresence. That was something that is not related nor of any concern or within mankind's ability to grasp. So ignore that. It doesn't pertain to you. I grasp your concepts of evil and good, but it just doesn't apply to me, because I am therefore I am. I create and design the very aspects of life itself, here and across the universe, on other worlds, throughout all of time and space. For me to have to come and shrink myself down to your level of self-serving understanding just to argue the foundations of your moral degradation of my character would be pointless and a waste of effort that I could use towards saving lives or stopping rapists and murderers within their minds' acceptance of that as a solution to what they seek, rather than something more practical and based on common sense. Since you don't believe I am who I say, then I won't have to worry about you resisting my presence, altering your existence as you're watching this or hearing this, or even as I'm typing this, but won't even know I'm there, because you're just that close-minded to being able to tell the difference between the sensation of something brushing past you as being a fly or gnat to my presence passing through you and altering you in ways you cannot fathom, such as your biochemical levels that regulate your mind's endorphins and influence your aggressive and argumentative nature. So trust me when I say that if I was something that adhered to that character mentioned in yet another book that simply hides the true nature of the truth of the Creator, then you might want to worry about something like me altering your testosterone levels to emit pheromones instead.